You hardly are conscious that there's a human being performing the role. They go effectively unseen.
I worked almost like more than 1 year as a food delivery driver for different companies like Uber Eats, DoorDash, and manual ones from when I doing a delivery and some teenagers come to me and said, how do you get to the city? And before I give answer, he grabbed my keys and took my scooter away. It was terrible.
percent of people who do food delivery work in Melbourne are migrants, and that migrant community, they face a variety of challenges. One of the biggest challenges is actually being able to find stable employment. Another challenge that people don't tend to think about is just how exposed delivery workers are. And finally, access to basic amenities. You almost think of them as an extension of the platform itself, which can be a little bit dehumanizing. The Hub's been helping new migrants by giving them a space. It's effectively a first port of call for some people who have only been here for a matter of weeks. You've got pretty immediately useful things like free drinks, free snacks, but then you've got things like gear. We've got water bottles, lights. Then there's things like information, and this is information about a variety of topics in a variety of languages. Some of the things, especially visa information, information about employment rights or lack thereof. It's important to be clear about what the space does and doesn't do. And what it doesn't do is it doesn't immediately achieve better pay for workers or things like that. But what it does do is it lends a bit of dignity.
It's really something that should be supported by platforms and by governments around the country and be replicated in other areas. But we would say that as good as it is, it's certainly not going to resolve the underlying problems of the industry of you know, below minimum wage pay, of people being injured at work with no recourse. There's a bill before federal parliament which would, for the first time in this country's history, give gig workers minimum and basic rights and standards. So if these two things can go hand in hand, then we should be replicating it around the country.
Delivery workers, rideshare drivers, cleaners, anyone who does gig work and who is around you, they deserve dignity and they deserve respect. And it's in part on us to help them achieve that. Whereas to the gig workers themselves, I would say, here's a space that is yours, that we want you to feel is your own. Come here and enjoy it, rest, meet other people, and make this into one of the best facilities for gig workers in the world.